I'm sitting here with Sox from Quantic. Let's start with your today's performance. How did you lose? How did you win? Yeah, describe in few words.
Okay. Well, the first game was against Fnatic. We were quite confident when we go against them, but we had a big advantage at the beginning, but we didn't gather too much. They start to pick up us around the map, and we lost everything from this. And yeah, they snowball on us with their heroes. So yeah, we just if we meet them in the near future, I think we will this time be better. Against Alliance, we take a convincing win. We finish in 26 minutes or something like this, so it was really good. We are really happy about this. I think it was the best team in our group, so yeah, that's really nice.
Can you explain those picks like Dazzle, Obsidian Destroyer, that, and Godblack always surprises with such picks? How did it work?
Well, this is all credit come to Godblack. He is always trying to find the best hero, even if they are not in the metagame. He is always thinking outside the box, so it's really nice. We couldn't practice a lot before the DreamHack, so we stay in our standard. Only this game against Alliance, we prepared something, obviously, with this tri-lane with Pugna, Naga, and Dazzle, and it worked out really well. So we were really happy. Yeah, but Godblack is kind of, I don't know.
But do you have more such interesting tactics for the playoffs?
Yeah, we have some. We have some, to be honest. Not all heroes will be switched. Maybe we can use some heroes, but we have some, for sure.
Okay. Are we going to see the tree?
Yeah, of course. If people let us, we will pick it every time. But at the moment, everyone is against us, banning it in the first phase. And it's actually really good for us, because it's a hero who is not used a lot. And against us, they have to ban it. So this is quite obviously quite good, because we can have some other heroes, you know.
Now you're facing Liquid. Tell us about the chances, and is it a good opponent?
I think it was the best opponent we can have, because the other were Navi and VP, I think.
Yeah.
For me, this is the two best team, maybe with Alliance as well. So it's a good opponent, but it's still really hard, you know, because they are really good, obviously. But we always believe that we can win anyone, so I think we will go with this mentality in the game, and we will try our best for sure.
Okay. A few words about the sponsors. Tell us the story. How did you find them? And if it's not a big secret, Villa told that first you're supposed to be sponsored by some other organizations. What were the options, and why did you choose Quantic?
I will not give any name of other organization, but Quantic was the best option we have for sure. At the moment, it's going very well. Well, we are only with them since 2 weeks, I think, even less. So they pay everything during the DreamHack. We have a notal, we have everything we need to perform well. So big thanks to them, obviously. As I said, for the other, it was just Quantic had the better offer, so we take it.
And what was worse from our organizations? I mean, from Russia, Ukraine. I know you should have had some proposals from them. What was not that good at it, as Quantic proposed?
Actually, we didn't have any proposal, I think, from CES organization. People thought we had a lot, but actually we didn't have a lot at all. Two or three, I think. And Quantic was the best one.
And who contacted first? You? Or they contacted you and said, oh, we want to sponsor you, you have good results?
After the international, we said that it was time to get a sponsor for our team, because we were going there and we wanted to attend every LAN. So it's us who come to all the organization, and that's how it was.
After DreamHack, what's your plan? Other more LAN tournaments that you're going to participate between international and DreamHack?
Yeah, we have a chance to go Star Ladder still, I think, because KP is not sure to go.
Yeah.
I hope they will not, so we can go. But there is EMS. We are in the group stage to qualify to the LAN event. And we have a pretty good group, I think. We can qualify, so there will be maybe two LAN. And after, no, nothing more. So after it will be the international, and we want anyway to at least got 3 weeks without anything to practice.
And money is not the problem for Quantic, because you go, if it's EMS, it's Poland, then Starladder Ukraine, it's quite far from France, and you have three people from there, so maybe it's expensive?
Actually, DreamHack is really expensive to go there, but other Ukraine and Poland, it's quite, it's not so expensive, to be honest. Yeah, it's really cheap. Last time EMS, they had a deal with the hotel where we played, so it was not so expensive actually, so I think we will be able to go anyway.
Okay. You've been to lots of tournaments already, I think, and even at the previous DreamHack, you were playing for Empire, right? Can you compare all the tournaments?
For me, I always love to... It was in Dota 1. It was in Dota 1 when I was going to Asus, spring and summer, I think. That was the two best LAN I attend, because in Cyber Arena, we are really close to the public, you know. And especially in Asus, we were playing and they were just behind us, supporting us. So it was really a good feeling. Me, I really like when we are really close. Obviously, last DreamHack summer, when we went to the... big stage, it was really good as well with all the crowd, but I think I will have to say for the best tournament it is the international with Valve, to go in their local, it was really awesome, and after in the Benayal Hall, yeah, it was also awesome. So yeah, I think the international scene.
Let's talk about then that you mentioned the international. You will be facing Rattlesnake from China for the final slot. Can you say your chances, and will you prepare just for them, or you will prepare for all other teams with the mind that you will pass them?
Yeah, that's actually a really good question. We asked each other what we wanted to do, and we really believe in us, so we will prepare for every team, not only Rattlesnake, because we really want to go there. And I think, yeah, we have a good chance. I think it will be 50-50 for me, actually. So yeah, we will go play this best of five, and hopefully we won and go to the main tournament.
And did you watch their qualifier, the Asian qualifier, where very surprised that Vixi Gaming didn't qualify?
Yeah, actually, I didn't follow too much the scene before, but I watched the qualifier, and people said it will be LGD and Vixi Gaming,
yeah,
for sure. So I was like, okay, we'll face Vixi. It was actually a really scary team with the player name, you know, because I knew ZSMJ and all others. But actually, I think, in my opinion, Vixi Gaming was playing better, but during their best of three against Rattlesnake, they just totally underperformed. And yeah, so for me it was like the final, it was 3-0 I think for LGD, and it was really some stomp almost all games. So yeah, I think Vixi Gaming was better at this time, but they didn't manage to win Rattlesnake, so...
Okay. About your recent performance online, I heard like a few days ago from an interview, I think from Fucking Mad, that you were not really concentrating on online matches. You were like relaxed, and that's why you lost quite a bit in recently. What, is it true?
Yeah, I think it's a bit like this for every team, you know. You are always more focused in with pressure and on LAN, but us especially, we have a small problem, yeah, for sure, in online. We are always on rush a bit because Mad is still working. Fonzie was still in school 2 weeks before the DreamHack, so we had some problem to always gather at the right time, etc. We also had some weird schedule, so yeah, it was a bit complicated, but now I hope it will be, everything will be fine, and we will finally be able to practice, to focus on matches online, and yeah, hopefully win.
And will you have some bootcamp, and if yes, where are you going to bootcamp before TI?
Yeah, we will have one for sure. We don't know yet where, because there is some, we wanted to do it in France, because we had some place to go, but we are not sure about the visa. Maybe it will be a bit complicated for both Silent and Koblak to come, so maybe we will go to Ukraine, maybe we'll go straight to USA because Quantic has a gaming house there. So yeah, we don't know yet.
You have lots of options, yeah. Tell us about the language barrier. Is it a really big problem? Are there any situations, even at DreamHack, that because of the language difference, you make some crucial mistake and, for example, you lose an important fight?
No, we never encounter this kind of problem at all. Goblak is speaking, sorry, English really well. And Silent, well, he has some trouble, but he can speak decent, you know, so there is no problem at all in game. And after game, we can talk together in English, Goblak can translate, during game, Goblak can, if Silent doesn't understand, can translate something, so no, there is no problem at all.
Okay. Do you think, like, Silent is really a silent person, from what you experienced?
Yeah, he is, definitely. But he's talking, always to say some good thing and something about the strategy and etc. But yeah, he's quite silent, even after games, etc. But he's really a nice guy and a great player.
The language again. What is more common in your conversations, Russian or French?
I think both. To be honest, maybe the only small problem we have, it's when we talk, like when Silent and Goblak talk, or when I talk to Mad or Funzy. Sometimes we can use some French or some Russian, but it's in both ways, you know. So maybe a bit more French because we are three French, obviously. But yeah.
And do you learn because of that some Russian words? Maybe you can remember what is like the most words that they speak between each other.
Yeah. We are starting a bit to learn Russian. I can say Privyet, Kak dela, Orosho. What else? Yeah, they love to use Bliat. I don't know what is it, but they love to use this. And yeah, well, that's it.
Okay. Let's talk about the French competitive thing. It's like, I think few years now or even more that there are the same names on the French stage. The teams basically just you mix, not mix, like you change the organization, the tag, the organization name, but the players are almost the same. You mix a bit, but why is that? Where are your new generation? Is Dota not popular in France? Or
yeah, Dota 2 is not really popular in France at all. I always tried when I was Virus, it was my main sponsor, to always gather a five Frenchman roster, because I really wanted to promote Dota 2 in France. It was my main goal. But when we start Dota 2, we had still a five-man roster French. We try our best to find a French sponsor as well, but it was impossible. No one was interested at all in Dota 2, so we decided to just go international. That's why we start with Cinderen and Kebab. And after, during all the year, it was really hard because Mad and Funzy were not always here. So I tried my luck alone a bit, it didn't work out. They came back, we formed a team together, and finally we find two great players, Goblak and Silent, before the qualifier for the international, so yeah.
Few words about the roster before Goblak and Silent. You're playing DD, but with Danish guys. Tell us, what was the issue that they parted ways with your team?
Actually it was a bit complicated. We start with, I think, Calculus and Neno. But 1 week after, it was like we wanted to full practice. We were all without job or school, so we wanted to really focus on this game. But Neno say it wasn't for him at all, so he decided to leave. After we tried a stand-in, but he was in school, so it started to be a bit complicated. We were not performing so well. People, for me, they didn't feel good in the team at all. I didn't feel good as well, so we just decided to split. I keep the name because I invite people to stay in tournaments, but it was basically a split, you know. So yeah, after I take back my old French teammates in. And we try other people, it works, it didn't work, it was, well, yeah.
But why did Link and Crit, they decided also to go from the roster?
Well, we have... when we play the game, our goal is to improve, to focus, to win. So every time we have not a bad argue, you know, but after games we like to argue a bit about what happened, if we won, even if we lost, even if we won, we want to argue, we want to talk about the game, to watch the replay, etc. And it wasn't working out with them, they didn't like it, so they just decided to leave. In good term, we were not, no problem, you know, but they just decided that it wasn't for them. They didn't want, they wanted really to have fun playing.
So it's like not their style or...
Yeah, we have a totally different approach of the game, you know, so yeah.
And do you feel now with Goblack and Silent, they fit really perfectly to your style, to in your team and everything?
Yeah, well actually I think it's more like we take the Goblack style, because for me really Goblack, it was the main player in Empire, at least in terms of strategy, so he came with this kind of draft. We all wanted to be led by Goblack, even fucking Matt, so there was no problem on this. We decided him to be captain. And I think it's going well at the moment, and I hope even after the intention we will stick together.
And were your teammates fine with Silent? Because yeah, you said they wanted Goblack, but Silent was like plus one, or you were considering them both before you invited Goblack?
I am friend with Goblack since a long time. Actually, my first Asus, I was fine. We always talk a lot. To be honest, I always wanted to play with this guy. For me, he's an awesome player and an awesome captain. So when he left Empire, I don't know what happened. We talked a lot. He said he wanted to try something, maybe keep with a Russian speaker but we talked. We said it wasn't working for us as well. So he said, well, I have a really good player, Silent. I didn't know him a lot. Well, I knew him from DreamHack, you know, but for me he was a great player, no problem. And he wanted, we swap a bit the roles, because Silent wanted to go back to carry. I think he was carry with Ozzy before, and even with Moscow 5 at some point. It was not Goblack plus one, it was Goblack and Silent. And for us it was the same, it was me, Mad and Fenzy.
What would you do if you don't pass, will not play at the international? Will you break up with the guys and what's the future in that case?
I don't know what will happen after, you know, but me personally I think we have a great potential. So even if we lost, I would like to stick together and keep playing together during the next year, and why not to go to the fourth international, you know? I really think we will stick together, and I really think we will beat Rattlesnake and go to the main tournament and do a great result.
Have you heard the recent scandal with Roxkiss?
Yeah, I read some stuff, yeah.
So what's your opinion? Did you actually try gambling? Maybe not Dota, but football or anything? Did you try it, and what's your opinion on that?
I don't have all the information, you know, so I will not talk about what happened, because I don't know, and I think everyone shouldn't make fast conclusions, because we don't really know yet what happened. So I think Roxkiss are great guys, great players, so I don't think we should go straight to against them and just so for me, no, I didn't do this kind of stuff, betting on other sports or anything, so I'm not in this.
Some words about the recent patch. As you mentioned, Goblack is thinking out of box. Can you share some insight? Maybe that is not so important on this tournament or in future, but some things that usual players, they don't think about that.
I think Baratheon have finally something to do in the meta for me. Yeah, I think it can be interesting to see him. I don't know where, I don't know how, but I think he can be interesting for sure. Actually, I really love every nerf Ice Frog made, because like last time after the international, when he nerfed Morphling, he kinda, for me at least, he kinda break him, you know, he breaks the hero, no one was picking him anymore. Here, he makes some good change, like in Gyrocopter, he had some some more, like 10 seconds on Placano more, you know. It was really good actually to nerf him a bit. On Batrider as well, to remove the range during the day of the vision. It was really smart as well, I think. Even on Wisp, it's a small nerf, but it's a good nerf in late game actually. For it's about the third spell, I don't know what's the name.
What do you think about BKB? Like, it's now less, the last charge is like 4 seconds, and the Lincoln Spear is buffed again. Like, it's buffed second or third time in a row.
For the BKB, I think it's good again, because I feel like every pro player are a bit, when they are playing carry, they are a bit too reliable about the BKB, you know. So they are not every time positioning good, but with this item you can do a bit like you want, you know. For the Lincoln Spear, I think it's a great item. The problem is more like there is not a lot, the hero who can do it are not so popular, you know, like Weaver, she's starting to be picked, so maybe we can see more. There is also the change on Bloodstone, but again, for me it's a night change actually, but again the problem is not really the items, it's more like heroes who can do it are not really played at the moment, so yeah.
And what do you think about her Huskar? Because some users think that actually Ice Frog made him even worse in the recent patch, because yeah, that protection from magic is not the thing that he actually needs to go back to pro games. So now he's not even used in pubs.
I kinda like this change. I feel like at the moment Dota there is not so much tank hero, you know, really tank hero like before. Like it was some, well, Bristleback is back in the game, so maybe we can see him a bit more. Huskar now for sure is dealing less damage, so that's a problem, but also he's really tanky against magic. So I feel like in situational game it can be a good addition. So yeah, I don't think he's worse, he's just different, you know.
Okay. The series of questions about Russian community. What do you know about Pro Dota? What did you hear? Did you visit the website and everything?
No, I didn't hear a lot about the community. I don't go too much on the site because I don't understand Russian, as you say. Actually, I know from Goblak that we had a bit of supporters, you know, from our team. So yeah, thanks to them, thanks to supporters, and I hope there will be more, you know.
Do you have support in France for your team, or there are no actually like big communities in Dota?
We have a small community who is supporting us for sure on a website, Dota to Bourbier, it's mean. Yeah, but I don't think there is so much French players and who are playing and really who are into the competition, like so no, we have some for sure, but not a lot.
Uh-huh. Are you playing Russian matchmaking when you practice, like I mean the server of course, or you prefer Western Europe?
Actually I put European West, East, and the last one I don't remember. I think it's Russia actually.
Yeah, yeah. Russia.
I'm playing a lot of matchmaking with Silent and his girlfriend, so Mila, I think, yes.
Yeah.
So yeah, we are playing everywhere.
And do you feel the difference between Western Europe and, for example, Russian server? Is there a difference in skill, in playstyle, in just matchmaking, in simple people?
Not so much different. The only thing is they are speaking Russian a lot, so I can't understand everything. But no, for me there is not a lot of difference. I heard a lot of people saying like Russian matchmaking sometimes are a bit troll or something, but not the case at all. So yeah, I like to play in both. I have no problem.
Okay. You've been to Ukraine, but I think you've never been to Russia, right?
No, never.
What do you know about Russia actually? What did you hear maybe from your teammates or just heard? What do you know?
Well, I know that they have a huge community between Dota. They really like Dota, I think. We can see it on every CES player Twitter and community. You know, they are always really supportive to their players. This is really nice, actually, I think. So yeah, they really like the game. So I don't know a lot more because I never went there, but think fans are more supportive than in West Europe.
And as you visited Ukraine most of the times, so what's the best that you like in Ukraine?
The best? To be honest, I only go to Cyber Arena, so I will say Cyber Arena, but hopefully next time we go, we can maybe visit a bit the city and etc. Yeah,
so you've never been to like different places in Kiev?
No, we were going straight to the Cyber Arena and go back to the hotel.
I think that's enough for the interview, it was quite long. So any final words, final shout-outs, anything you want to say?
Shout-out to Quantic and their sponsor. Thanks for them. We are here because of them, so we are grateful. Shout out to my father, who will probably watch the interview. And all the guys who support us during this tournament, and I hope we will not disappoint them.
Thanks, and see you.